In this tutorial, you will learn how you can use Notion as a social media scheduler. So I will show you how you can use a database like this. So we create a database of everything we want to post to our different social media platforms, and then how we can automatically publish that on those platforms with a tool called Integromat. So let's just dive right in and then I'll explain how it works. So the first thing that you need to do is you need to create a database like this. So simply create a new page, turn it into a database, and then add all these properties over here. So we have a name property. So this is basically just a little description for ourselves to tell us what this thing is about. Then the post that you want to post. So this could, for example, also be the tweet, the post for your Facebook page, and so on. Then the URL of an image. So if you want to add an image to, for example, a Facebook post, to Instagram or Twitter, then we need to populate this property over here. So for this, we use the URL type property and we call it image. Then we also have a property called URL. So this is also a URL property type. And this is handy if you, inside your post, for example, inside your Facebook post, want to link to a website. So for example, in this example, I have a post about a new article on my website. And then over here, I link to my website. I'll show you in a bit how that works also. And then over here, we have a multi-select type property. We call this platform, and this is where we automatically want to post this post to. So then over here, we add those options. So here, I, for example, have Twitter, Facebook page, Facebook Mastermind, which is basically just a group that I have, and then Instagram. And then if you would have multiple Twitter accounts, for example, what you can also do is you can maybe also add the username. So then over here, you would edit like this. But I'm not going to do that because I only have one of each of these platforms. Now then the publish date and time. So when do we want to publish this post? And then last but not least, we have status. So this is a select type property. We call this status. And then the options are draft, ready to publish, and published. So this will tell us we draft if we're still working on this thing, ready to publish, if it's ready to be published. And then with Integromat, I will show you in a bit, then after it's published, we will automatically change this to published. So that's basically this over here. And then if you want, you can also create different views for this, right? So this is just like a table view. But what is also cool is you can, for example, also use a calendar view. So then you can really have like a content calendar of when, of what gets posted when to your social media. And if you're then like, oh, hey, I'm posting two things over here, maybe I want to move this one to tomorrow or to next week, something like that. So super cool, right? So then what we need to do is we need to create a scenario in Integromat. And a scenario is basically just a little automation. So what you're going to need is this. I'm also going to put a copy of this below this video so that you can just import it into Integromat if you want to save you some time. So in case you're not familiar with Integromat, Integromat is basically just a tool that allows you to connect applications and websites together with each other without any programming knowledge. So for example, in this case, we're connecting Notion with Twitter and with Facebook. And then if you want, you could also add, for example, Instagram or maybe even LinkedIn to this as well. So it's just a handy tool to connect all these tools with each other without any programming knowledge. And I know that this might look a little bit overwhelming, but it's basically just the same thing over and over again for all these different platforms. So let me explain how this works. So in the beginning, we have this module over here. So they call this the trigger module. This is going to be what is going to be triggering the scenario. So over here, we see this little clock icon. And it tells us that this is a scheduled scenario. So this scenario is going to run every 30 minutes. And then here under advanced scheduling, you can see from Monday till Friday, because I'm myself not publishing on Saturdays and Sundays. So that's why I did not check those over here. So every Monday to Friday, every 30 minutes, what it's then going to do is going to search for objects. So this is the Notion module, search objects. And then it's going to search inside this database over here, and it's basically going to search for something that is ready to publish, and the date and time of when it has to be published is roundabout right now. So to do that, what we do over here is you set search objects to database items, then database ID you set to social media scheduler, so that's like the name of this database over here, right? And then we have to add some filters. So filters are basically just conditions that we put into it. So it's going to search for items inside the database. And then what we put into those filters, only the things that match those filters will be returned. So you can see that the first condition inside our filter is that the status should be equal to ready to publish. So it's going to search for things, and only things will be returned where the status over here is ready to publish. So if something would be in draft, then it would not be found basically with that module. Now then, obviously we do not want to get everything that is ready to publish, right? We want to check if the publish date and time is roundabout right now. So why do I say roundabout right now? And I have to admit, it's maybe a little bit confusing, so I will just try to explain this step by step. So what you can do here is you can say publish date and time equals, and then you could say now, right? That would be like the easy solution if the publish date and time is right now. But the problem is that this scenario is only going to run every 30 minutes. Only every 30 minutes is going to check if something has to be published right now. So if that publish date and time that we set over here is not exactly matching when the scenario is running, then it will not find anything. So that's why we are using here the @minutes function. So this sounds a little bit techy, but it's a date and time function. And what it's doing here, we have now, and then we subtract 30 minutes. So then over here, we basically say, okay, the published date and time should be on or after 30 minutes ago. So basically the published date and time should be in the last 30 minutes. And then over here, we create another one, and then we say, and the published date and time should be on or before now plus 30 minutes. So basically what this filter is doing, it is searching for items inside our social media scheduler database, and it's only returning things that the status is equal to ready to publish and the published date and time that we set over here was in the last 30 minutes or it's in the next 30 minutes. And if that is the case, then the item will basically be found, and then the scenario is going to start, and then it's going to publish it to our social media. So a little bit confusing, but I also created a separate tutorial about date and time functions over here that you maybe want to check out. Now then sorts, we do not fill out anything over here. And then here we have a limit. So that's the maximum number of things that can be found inside this database during this one scenario execution every 30 minutes. So personally, I just set this to 5 so that it will only get a maximum number of 5 items. It would be very rare if I would want to post more than that during that time. But if you want, you can also change this to 20 or maybe even to 1, but not super important. I would just leave it to 5. Now then we click here, okay. And then we created this. Now then we have this one over here that's called testing. So this is a tweet, right? I want to post this to the platform Twitter, and I have a post over here that says like, hey everyone, this is just a post to quickly test the automated posting from Notion. And then here I also have an image that I want to post with that tweet. And this is when I want to post that tweet. So this is like 2 minutes from now when I'm recording this tutorial, and the status here is ready to publish. So right now, if I would click here, run this module only, so that only this module will run, then you see over here that we have an output of one bundle. So it found one thing that needs to be posted to our social media. Now then if we go to properties value, then you see also all those things down here. So here we have the name, right? So here it says testing. So that's here, this one, testing. So then if we go, for example, here to post, and then over here to plain text, then you see here the thing that we wanna post, right? So here you just find all those things. Super cool. So then after something was found, it's going to continue into something that they call a router. So a router allows you to split the scenario into multiple routes so that it can follow different routes. Now then what I did over here is that I created filters in those routes. So then you can, for example, see that this one is called Twitter, this one is called Facebook page, this one is called Facebook mastermind. And then what I did is I check over here, if the property value platform is equal to Twitter, then it will continue up here. If it's equal to Facebook page, it will continue over here. So it's basically just getting the item over here and then it's going into the router so that our scenario will be split into a few routes, and then it's going to check the property value of platform over here and then the name. So if I would here now click run once so that we can test the whole scenario, then you also see what happens. So here we click run once, then it's going to find that item, and then you see over here it went to Twitter. It did not go over to Facebook page or Facebook mastermind, because here you see the filter was not a match. You see these like zeros, right? And over here you see a one. And then if you go in here, you also see here that the condition inside that filter was a match. So then we go over here, and then here I have a path for images. So if the database here has an image, so if we have a URL for the image, then it will continue up here. Then we use a HTTP module to get a file. So we're basically downloading that image into Integromat. And then we posting the tweet. So then over here, you can see how we do that. So here we have the status. So we use the plain text of the post and we use the URL. So if there was a URL over here, then it would also post the URL. But now because it's empty, it's not going to post anything over there. And then we upload here an image or GIF. And here under attachment, you see that we selected the source file from the HTTP module get a file. So it's basically going to get the data from this module over here. And then we went into an update database item module. And then inside this module, it is changing the status to published. You can see that down here, status published. So right now, if you go back over here, you see that the status changed over here from ready to publish to published. And if I now go to Twitter, then if I refresh the page over here, then you see right now that it also posted this tweet 1 minute ago that says like, hey everyone, this is just a post to quickly test. So I will delete this one over here. But then you can see how this scenario works. So if it did not have an image, I can maybe also show you that. So here, if you would remove the URL to the image and we would change this back to ready to publish, if I now go over here, save, click run once, then you see it's going to find that item again. It will go again over to Twitter because the value of platform is Twitter. And then it does not have an image. And then it's posting the tweet and it's again changing the status to published. So here you see that now it says published. And now if I refresh this page again, then you see now that we have this tweet over here. Hey everyone. And this time it does not have an image. So pretty cool, right? That this is possible. You can just add items over here. Then this scenario is going to start every 30 minutes. And then if there is an item inside that database of which the status is equal to ready to publish and the publish time is in the last 30 minutes or in the next 30 minutes, then it's going to get that item. It's going to continue. Then it will go through the appropriate platform route basically. And then in this case, it was Twitter. And then if it did not have an image, then we post the tweet and we update the item inside our database to make sure that it's going through the right route. Depending on that image, I also created a filter after the router. So here I just check if image contains HTTP, because if we have an image URL over here, then it's going to contain HTTP and it will continue up here. And then if not, I created a fallback route. So this will be used in case where the bundle, so basically the item, could not continue in any other route, then it's going to continue down here. So this is how you create this social media scheduler. I think it's super cool that you can create a database like this and then automatically publish this to your social media. So I know that I maybe went a little bit fast over this. So if you want, if you're like, hey, I want to implement this, I want to know exactly how this works, I also have a more extended version of this tutorial that you're watching right now. I did not want to make this one super long for YouTube, but on my website, I also have one where I'm really building the scenario out step by step. So if you go down to the description, you'll also find a link to that. And if you have any questions about this, just let me know.